Ports are an important addition to network communication, but if that were all the transport layer did, the application layer would be left to cope with some common problems. Given the terrific complexity and scale of the internet, it's no surprise that packets occasionally get lost or delivered out of order. It sure would be nice to have some kind of acknowledgement that the packet got through. That way, we could resend a packet if necessary and achieve more reliable communication. And for larger messages that need to be broken up into lots of smaller packets, it would be nice to have some kind of numbering system so that if they arrived out of order, they could be reassembled. Moreover, we would like to know if we are overwhelming the recipient with too many packets too fast, or if we are causing congestion on some link in the route, so that we can be a good citizen and slow down. All of this functionality is provided by the Transmission Control Protocol, or TCP, inside the transport layer. TCP doesn't just start off firing packets towards some destination without warning. The conversation begins and ends with a polite handshake to mark the beginning and end of an exchange. Once the connection is established, data can go both ways from initiator to recipient and vice versa. Let's take a look at an example. I'll use some unrealistically small numbers to keep things simple. And I'll rename the initiator GT and the recipient Udacity. At this point, the connection is pretty much symmetric, so the vocabulary for the handshake becomes confusing. GT issues a request and sets a push flag, meaning, send me your data. Then Udacity begins transmission back. Great. But what if one of the packets is dropped? That is to say, they don't make it across the internet. In our example, let's suppose that the first packet doesn't make it. We would like a way to detect the situation. Here is TCP's solution. After the initial handshake, packet, or segments as they are called in TCP parlance, indicate how much data the other side should have received already, and also how much data the sender has received. The former is called the sequence number, and the latter, the acknowledgement number. During the handshake, both of these numbers get incremented by 1. In this scenario, TCP will be able to detect the drop packet because the next message thinks that 9 bytes is the amount that should have been received, but in reality, GT has only received the initial acknowledgement. You might think that GT would send a packet saying, could you resend that please? But actually the system works by positive acknowledgements instead of requests for retransmission. If the packet had gone through, the traffic should have looked like this. So even though GT doesn't really have anything to say to Udacity, he should have been sending empty acknowledgement packets to Udacity, indicating that the packets were received. To make an analogy to human conversation, this is like saying, uh-huh, periodically, to let the other person know you are listening. Going back to the case where the first packet is dropped, we now see that upon receiving the second packet, GT would see that a packet has been dropped and simply won't acknowledge the first one or the latter one. After enough time has passed, Udacity will notice that it hasn't received an acknowledgement for that first packet and will retransmit it. When GT receives the retransmitted package, he can now send an acknowledgement for both packets, saying that he has received 17 bytes worth of data. Together, this system of acknowledgements and sequence numbers helps achieve the first two goals. I'll have to refer you to a networking class for a more complete discussion of the third goal, but I do want to briefly discuss the idea of window size. In this example, Udacity has sometimes sent out a packet before it received an acknowledgement of the previous one. This is typical for TCP, and how much one side is allowed to get ahead of himself in the conversation is controlled by a window size parameter. A good way to visualize this is by drawing the data that needs to be sent as a long bar and then dividing it into the packets that actually get sent. We have the packets that have been sent and acknowledged, the ones that have been sent but haven't been acknowledged yet, and the unsent packets. This middle part, representing the packets sent out but not acknowledged, represent the window, and during transmission, the window will slide across to the right. The window size puts a limit on how wide this window can get. If the window is too small, then it can slow the connection down, as the sender has to stop and wait for an acknowledgement for every packet. If the window size is too big, then there's a risk that it will overflow the buffers of the recipient or of one of the hops along the way, resulting in packet loss. So it's important to get the window size right. You can explore other aspects of TCP's flow and congestion control by following the links in the instructor notes.